La muy leal and noble ciudad, or the most loyal and noble city, a distinct title given to Iloilo by no less than the Queen Regent Maria Cristina of Spain during the last decade of Spanish colonial period in the Philippines. Historian Demizonza explained why the 1896 revolution was a failure, especially in the Visayas.
Iloilo really was a cosmopolitan city. They were enjoying what they call la dulce vida, the sweet life. In fact, when the revolution broke out in the last week of August near Manila and Caloocan, on September, the Ilonggo elite were quick to react. But surprise of surprise, they did not join. The response was not to join the revolution.
Iloilo was the last overseas province of Spain, one that benefited most from Spanish rule. Education was among the benefits for the voluntarios, or the Spanish allies during those times. In Santa Barbara, young Martin Delgado was a scholar of the church before he became commander in the Visayas and Mindanao. 68-year-old Martin Luso Delgado talks about his grandfather.
He was a very religious man, no? He was had a close relationship with the Spanish and Filipino clergy. That's why he was made a scholar by the parish priest here, Father Mateo Rodriguez.
There's a museum dedicated to General Martin Delgado, who in November 17, 1898, led the cry of Santa Barbara.
We have a marker there, no, in the corner of Taft and Delgado Street also. So that is the place where the sidula was. So they call it the cry of Santa Barbara, reminiscent of the cry of Pugad Lawin in Luzon, where in the Katipuneros, I think, also had some fort manifestation, and also the cry of in the U.S. there is also another cry there, which is also the start of a American Revolution against the British. That's why they call it the cry on Santa Barbara.
Such inauguration called for a flag, which was made by a spinster from Haro, Iloilo, by the name of Patrocinio Gamboa. A replica of the Philippine flag was made, but the problem is how to transport it from the two towns. Mater Gamboa, a distant relative of the spinster, recalls how a lady concealed the flag in her waist using a traditional hand-woven fabric. She easily passed through the Spanish guards while staging a quarrel with a fake husband. The flag raising in Santa Barbara was the first in 1898 outside Manila, symbolizing independence. 117 years after, Mayor Dennis Superficial says it is only proper to hold the Independence Day celebration in Iloilo.
First Philippine flag that was raised outside Luzon was here in Santa Barbara. So that is the history, the role of the church, the role of the Victory Plaza, which wherein we are going to hold also the Independence Day this coming June 12.
Our hero's contribution to the freedom that we enjoy now will be forever be remembered. Reggie Adosto, ABS-CBN News, Iloilo.